If you've been a consistent user of internet, you must have come across the term malware, which can be in the form of never-ending ads on your screen or locking system or asking for payments. In fact, virus is also a type of malware. So how exactly does it affect you, and most importantly, how can you protect yourself from it? So let's find that out in this video. And in case you don't want to wait, these are the topics that we'll discuss in this video, and you can hit the timestamp to skip to the topic you're interested in. So let's get started. Malware is a type of software or program that is malicious and it can harm your computer or any smart device. Simply, it is a code developed by some person, most probably by a cyber attacker, which is designed to do different tasks depending on what they are looking for. They can steal personal data, which may include bank information and hence stealing the money, or encrypting or locking your files, and sometimes they can just monitor what the user is currently doing. There are different types of malware like viruses, adware, spyware, or ransomware. But before we get into the details of these, let's first understand what are some common ways through which malware can be injected into your device, so you can protect yourself. Well, any file on internet can have malware. However, mostly these can be found in third-party software or apps that people download from random sites. Pirated software games can also have malicious program that you wouldn't notice and will be running in the background as you're installing the game or program. Another way these can be delivered to you is through USB or by an email, which is known as phishing attack. We discussed this topic in another video. You can check that out to find more about it. But simply put, an email that would seem like it is from some service you are subscribed to, but it'll just be a disguise and will contain malicious links or files. There are many other ways that we cannot discuss in this short video. These attacks can be mild or disastrous depending on what you were attacked with, but any malware that stays too long in your device without you knowing about it can have significant effect on your system. So let's now talk about the common type of malware and then we'll get to the solution. Most common type of malware is virus that many people would have heard it by now. It is a type of malware that can execute itself and injects its code into another software or program to take some malicious action and spread further. And yeah, you heard me right. It can execute itself by an automated process, so you don't always have to be involved to spread the virus. Another type of malware is worm. Well, just like a worm, these can infect different devices and spread to different machines on the network, resulting in affecting more than just a user who got the malware. In fact, worm can infect the entire network really quickly. But then there's spyware, which is designed to spy on user. It can also collect information such as password, username, or bank information. Then there's ransomware, which got quite popular since past few years. It locks and encrypts your file with special key that only attacker has, and then they demand money in exchange of the key. But there's a catch here. Even after you give them the money, there's no guarantee that you'll get the files back. There are some other malware also like adware, trojan, keylogger, and rootkit. You can pause the screen to read more about them. Now we'll move toward the solution. There are different ways that can help you in preventing the malware. First and foremost, you should install anti-malware program, and then there are some healthy practices that you can adapt to minimize the risk of getting attacked. You should always keep your antivirus and other apps and programs updated, as it is easier for hackers to exploit the vulnerabilities in the older version of program. So whenever there's an update officially from the app provider, don't ever ignore that. Always keep an eye out for emails from unknown sources or links that take you to unencrypted sites, or attached files that are sent to you through social media platforms. They can also contain malware. So this is it for this one. I hope you got something out of it. So I'll see you guys in the next one.